It's what it feels like to be homeless. And that hasn't changed at all in this process. And how quickly one descends into really scary zones of consciousness when you're invisible. When you're invisible. And it's worse, and I keep telling people, it's actually worse than being invisible. It's a black hole that everyone is afraid to get sucked into. You're radiating failure, being homeless on the street. No one wants to come in. And for me, the profundity of my experience doing this, you know, the first day we did it, what we call the test day to see if this was going to work, the master place, and the camera was in the Starbucks, and no one on the street could see the camera. But I'm out there, first time to see if this is going to work. And I mean, I'm still making movies, I'm still out there, you know, so I was a little scared, actually, and anxious about, one, as a filmmaker, but personally, that I would be that naked out there in the streets. No one paid any attention to me. No one saw me.
You had the cup.
I had a cup. I started talking after a while. We went on for 45 minutes shooting this thing straight, because we shot digitally, very long takes sometimes. And I started a bit approaching people. Not harassing them, but just approaching. Can you help me out? Spare you. Can you help me out? Spare you. No eye contact. Even when someone gave me a dollar bill, no eye contact. That to me was the first time I've really felt inside of what that is. And for me, look, I come here and you want to hear what I have to say. You've seen my movie. I'm iconic in some way. And it's romantic in some way. I'm the same guy as on the street. And no one wanted to come here. No one wanted to hear his story. So for me, it's a profound experience of existentialism, of how relative it all is, all of it, existence itself, certainly consciousness.